Well, good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Hello. Good evening, everyone. Hello. Hello, everyone. Hello. So, welcome everyone. Can everyone in the back hear me? Can you hear me? Okay. First of all, I consider it an honor to be standing here with all of you 50 years after we graduated from Cathedral High School. As many of you know, planning a reunion or any type of event takes time and energy. Planning, coordinating comes with a fair amount of stress and requires cooperation. So I'd like to start out by recognizing and thanking our reunion chair, Mary Seifert MacMiller. For the masterful job that she has done orchestrating this event. She worked tirelessly. And it's not a one-person task by any means. So thanks to the committee of Karen Gafford Seifert, Sid DeLeo, Barb Soffert, Monica Grubel-Preckel, Myron Moore, and Ron Soffert. Did I miss anybody? But most of all, our reunion needs participation. And that's all of you. So in addition to the locals and the people in Twin Cities and surrounding areas, we are so happy to have Gary Berg from Texas. All my exes live in Texas. From Michigan, Tish Olson Vanderham. Sin Sherry from California. Roger Flegel, Colorado. Mark Knight from Indiana. Rich Hesse and Karen Gafford Seifert from the great state of Wisconsin. Ooh, yeah. We also appreciate the presence of our eighth grade teacher, Judy Luker. So thank you. We'd also like to give a quick thank you to our class photo photographer, Matt Sparlin, and John Walsh, our videographer and still photo taker. And we have printouts. We have printouts with their contact information if you choose to order. Okay, so our graduating class is a blend of St. Mary's and Holy Trinity grade schools. And while looking through memorabilia, St. John's and Searles, thank you, yes, St. John's and Searles. While looking through memorabilia, I ran across a list of my morning kindergarten class taught by Mrs. Charlotte Anderson. And it included Karen Wolf, Mary Eckstein, Mary Seifert, and the cutest guy in the class who sat next to me in the alphabet circle, Mark Stephen Knight. Did any of you PM kindergarten, afternoon kindergarten? Karen, oh, morning? Sue Marty, were you in my class then? Okay, your name was not on my list, but... Okay, yeah, right. What? Yeah. So it was just fun to go... We've been together that long, essentially 13 years. So we made it through high school without Google and Wikipedia. And thankfully, without social media. We are baby boomers who enjoy senior discounts, Medicare, Social Security. We've known each other before we were mothers, fathers, grandparents, aunts, and uncles. And since then, we have loved dearly and we've lost greatly. I'd like to take just a few minutes to honor our classmates who have passed and reached their final destination in heaven.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. And my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your.
We do have envelopes at the, they're at the shelf where you came in. If you'd like to donate to New All Mary Catholic Schools, or no, the Father Alexander Berg, whatever that is, Berghold, Bergs. Anyway, and they're going to be on the shelf, and you're all going to have to pass by it when you leave. So please, if you choose, you take one. Okay. All right, so we all have a birth date and we all have a date of death, and you saw that on the PowerPoint. And I'd like to read to you a poem. It's by Linda Ellis, and it talks about the time in between our birth and our death. It's that dash in between. I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates on the tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of birth and spoke the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For that dash represents all the time they spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved them know what little line is worth, that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the houses, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way other people feel, and be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? Okay, that was a lot to think about. So now we have a very short, quick audience participation part of the program. It is 1972 trivia. There are 10 questions, and I'm not sure if you could just yell out the answer if you know it. The first one we hear correctly. This was the only thing I could get from Cathedral that was free. These are. They're lanyards, okay. Fashion pants. That is correct. You said Tish, okay? Only have one pair. That you are correct. Question number two. Average price of gas in 1972. 30, who said 30?
35.
You're short by one, 36. Give it to Patty, Patty gets the lanyard. John, Patty Ravens. Okay. In 1972, what was the average price of a home? Who said 28,000? Gary Berg. 27,600. Somebody's got to help me with the lanyards here. Roger. It goes to Gary Berg. All right. In 1972, we all grew up on Wonder Bread. What was the average price of a loaf of bread?
19.
Who said 25 cents? Steve Laraway. 25 cents. Okay. In 1972, what was the average price of a car? Just average, not really nice car. Or who said what? Who said 3,500? It's a little higher. Yes, it is, Don. Yeah. No. $3,900. Look it up, Don. Okay. 1972. Who said it? Monica. Biggest scandal, 1972. Political scandal. Watergate. That is correct. Monica? I know that. Okay, this was a top three song. The top song in 1972 was Roberta Flack. What was it? The First Time I Ever Saw Your Face. But this was a top three song on the music charts, and I'm going to give you a little hint. Everybody says, "Hey Jude."
Hey Jude.
Who said American Pie?
Maggie Man.
And who said it? Patrick Pat. Okay, it goes to Patricia. 1972 top movie. Who said Godfather? Perry Fox, you are the winner. All right, there were three TV shows that were constantly at the top. No, it wasn't. Don Manderfeld, All in the Family. Another one, Sanford and Sons. Another one, Maude. Another one, MASH. Okay, here's the last question. In 1972, what was the... No, no. You're okay, wait. So you said what, a dollar? Myron said... Okay, who said 150? Well, you win again, so you can. It was $1.50.
How about the price of a hamburger at the Red Eye Drive-In?
Five for a dollar. 25 cents a piece. 19 cents. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we have a special treat. Master soothsayer, seer, and sage, and former travel agent for E.T. Please welcome the great mystic from the East, Karnak, the Magnificent! Next time, send a postcard.
May a crazed yak siphon your sister.
Well, I hold in my hand the envelopes. A child of four could plainly see that these envelopes have been hermetically sealed in a mayonnaise jar on Tony Fleck's porch since noon today. No one knows the answers to the questions in these envelopes. But in your borderline majestic way, you will divine the answers having never seen the questions. Isn't that right?
That is correct, sir.
All right. The first envelope.
Whoop-dee-doo.
Whoop-dee-doo.
Whoop-dee-doo. What do you call something that is no big deal, or our favorite basketball song at Cathedral?
Whoop-dee-doo.
Whoop-dee-doo.
All right, the second envelope in my hand. The answer is...
I need complete silence here. C-scope.
C-scope.
C-scope. What is the nickname for a colonoscopy, mouthwash for a greyhound, or a cathedral yearbook?
C-scope.
C-scope.
Audience claps.
This is Ed McManderfeld here, isn't he awesome? The Cortland Cutoff, Shag Road, Flandreau, Shells Park, that's enough.
Cobbs Creek. How do you remember all those answers?
I don't know. It's my mystical abilities. Name the best makeout places back in 1972.
The next envelope, Karnak.
Karnak. Silence. Weed.
Weed.
Weed. What really killed the fish in Sister Bellarmine's aquarium? Weed.
Weed.
Silence. Andre the Giant.
Andre the Giant.
Wilt the Stilt. Sister Joseph. Name three tall people. Must concentrate. Is there a fly in the room? Senior lounge.
Senior lounge.
Where do people our age go for a drink? Now we're getting political. Get ready. No. I'm kidding. Earth Day.
Earth Day.
Zero population growth.
Zero population growth.
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
I'm not going to repeat that.
You're such a goody two-shoes, Ed.
I am.
Name five good things our era was noted for.
Woo! Sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Do you know what you're doing?
It's hard to when I get interrupted.
Okay.
May the fleas of a thousand camels nest in your armpits.
Whoop, whoop.
Pep rally.
Pep rally.
Pep rally. What do we call gathering our strength to get up off the couch? A Tom Hanks movie, a bus line, and a cathedral mascot.
Tom Hanks movie, a bus line, cathedral mascot.
What is a greyhound?
Oh, what is a greyhound?
I almost wanted to say, Nancy, what's a gonad? Remember that?
Right.
Who can forget?
Sister Bellamy interrupted me while I was talking in class and said, Nancy, what's a gonad?
And of course she didn't know what it was. No, yeah. Kidding. All right. Senior skip day.
Senior skip day.
Senior skip day.
Senior skip day.
Is there an echo? What do you call every day in retirement?
Senior skip day.
Yeah. Sister Angelica, Remington, and Attila.
Sister Angelica, Remington, Attila.
Name a nun, a gun, and a hun. This one's gonna take you back. The tunnel.
The tunnel.
What do you walk through to get to the light?
The tunnel.
This is the naughty. Nippy.
This is naughty.
It isn't naughty. You need to take your goody, your two shoes off, goody. Nippy.
Nippy.
What do you call cold weather, a place to go smoke cigarettes, and the no bra look?
Nippy.
Was I the only one who was smoking down at Nippy's? Come on.
You remember Nippy, Reese, Nippy's?
Remember Nippy's? Yeah.
Okay, Karnak, the last but not least, the last envelope.
The final. May the bird of paradise nest in your underwear. Jeez. Gonad. What did people not yell to cheer on Nadia Comaneci in the Olympics?
Gonad.
Gonad.
Karnak, thank you for your wisdom and your divine magical powers. Thank you for bearing with us during the entertainment portion of our program. And that's all that we have. So I hope that you all can spend more time sharing memories and learning about your friends and your families and just reminiscing. And thank you again. It means so much to us to have you all here. So have a great rest of the night.